Welcome to the Department of Otolaryngology here at the University at Buffalo. Our program is very clinically oriented and we pride ourselves on diversity, inclusion, and camaraderie.
One of the big strengths of the program here in Buffalo is our operative experience. We have a lot of talented community and hospital-based faculty who really let us get our hands dirty in the OR. We often have more ORs running than we have residents to cover, so you get your autonomy early and often. And our residents routinely graduate with more than 2,000 cases over the course of their residency.
The emphasis here at this program is mainly on the operative experience and becoming a really good surgeon. It's a graduated responsibility where you get more and more responsibility as the years go on. You get to do a lot of operating while you're on call, as well as obviously schedule cases throughout the day. By the time you're chief resident, you're very comfortable doing almost all of the general and specific ENT surgeries.
We experience a lot of variety in ENT at our three practice sites. At Erie County Medical Center, we experience complex trauma as well as head and neck cases. At the Buffalo Niagara Medical Campus, this includes Oshai Children's Hospital, Gates Vascular Institute, Roswell Park Cancer Institute, as well as Buffalo General Hospital.
At our Sisters of Charity Hospital, we get more of our taste of community-based medicine. We get our general ENT laryngology, as well as the breadth and depth of facial plastics with our chairman, Dr. Sherris.
We experience pediatric ENT, neuro-otology, otology, and head and neck cancer cases.
So the call schedule here is really where you learn how to be an ENT surgeon and get to practice on your skills independently. It's a very manageable, starts as a second year where you take primary call every fourth night. As a third year, you also still take primary call every fourth night, but this will be focused on non-trauma call. And then as a fourth and fifth year, you take backup call where you're supervising your twos and threes, mainly over the phone or text communication, but also can come in and help them out.
Many of our alumni end up in general practice and they also can end up in fellowship. Over the last 10 years, our residents have gone 50-50 either way.
We have an outstanding research program and the residents are encouraged to present at national meetings as well as work with faculty within our department or other departments, both on clinical and basic science research.
It's hard not to fall in love with Buffalo, honestly.
Living in Buffalo has been a wonderful experience. It's truly a big city with a small city feel.
Buffalo offers a great community.
We have a wonderful park system. There are a ton of outdoor activities, especially when the weather's good. There's outdoor concerts, free yoga.
It's also very light traffic, so which is very convenient when you're going to the hospitals or going or on call.
In the wintertime, we've got skiing, snowboarding, sledding.
There's also many great foods and restaurants to check out.
Everyone who comes to Buffalo ends up falling in love with it.
Everyone here is very supportive and here to make sure that you succeed in every endeavor that you would like.
I know residency can be hard. It's full of highs and lows, and it's really important to have a good group of people to help support you through it.
We hope that this introductory video has given you some ideas, and we welcome your application to our program.